to get some truth of the reality on the ground in Georgia, specifically the city of Atlanta. We have the mayor here, Keisha Lance Bottoms. Mayor, thank you so much for joining us on Primetime.
Thank you for having me, Chris. And I just want to say I'm so grateful that you're doing better. My entire family has been thinking about you and praying for you and your family.
Mayor, thank you so much. I am blessed. I am lucky. My wife has once again proven that she is the stronger part of the couple. The missus powered through this. She's out of quarantine. She dealt with it in a fraction of the time. So we're among the blessed. And you know what? My kids, Mayor, they feel exactly what you're being told by your constituents. Man, I got to get out of here. I got to get back. It's been too long. I can't take it anymore. And that is strong medicine. The mayor says in Georgia, I hear you. And it's been long enough. Now, what is your level of comfort? Then when all of these appetizing things open back up, things you know you want, Madam Mayor, and that I want, if I lived in Atlanta, that you can do the testing, do the tracing, and do the treatment that may be necessary. What's your level of confidence?
Chris, I have four kids in my house, and no sooner than the governor made his announcement, my 18-year-old, who will be 18 tomorrow, came running into the room to announce to me that the governor said he could leave home. So as a parent, I am concerned, because what I know is that when I look at the data that we receive from our public health department each day, our numbers are going up. We get a count at noon and we get one at 7 p.m. When I look at the 24-hour period for the 7 p.m. count we got today, our death rate is up by almost 14%. Our positives up almost 7%. And we are not testing asymptomatic in people with mild symptoms. And so it concerns me. I have a great working relationship with our governor. But I did not speak with him before he made this announcement. I spoke with Mayor Hardy Davis, who is the mayor of Augusta, Georgia, the second largest city in the state. He did not speak with the governor. I've spoken with several leaders across the state. So we really are at a loss, and I am concerned as a mother and as the mayor of our capital city.
Well, the governor makes the talking to him part easier, because he says, you don't have to talk to me because you can't undo this. No locality can overturn this statewide reopening. Now, that's a political play to make this uniform and for him not to have to deal with infighting. And that's okay on one level. But now the bigger concern will rest directly on his shoulders, which is why, Madam Mayor, we invited him on tonight. The governor's invited every night to come on and make the case on this. He says you guys are in a better position than you were a month or so. And the data shows that over the last couple of weeks, you've seen a flattening in cases. Is that enough for you to have confidence that there's enough testing capacity, there's enough treatment capacity of what could happen in Atlanta, which is a huge density area?
Chris, if we're in a better position, it's because we have been aggressive in asking people to stay home. That's why we are in a better position. Our metro area has about 6 million people, more than half the population in the entire state, but we have less than half of the people who have tested positive. Where are our hotspots? Our hotspots are in areas like Bibb County around Macon that didn't shut down. When we open up houses of worship, we have to think about Albany, Georgia, which has had one of the worst outbreaks in the country. That, by and large, came from two funerals. And so I'm perplexed that we have opened up in this way. And again, I can't stress enough, I work very well with our governor, and I look forward to having a better understanding of what his reasoning is. But as I look at the data, and as I talk with our public health officials, I don't see that it's based on anything that's logical.
But here's the strong pull. And what do you say to people, literally in your own house, when they say, I got to get out of here. I got to get out. I've had enough. The governor says it's okay. Everybody's sick of this. It's been long enough. Everybody's not dying. It seems like we're doing better. More and more states are starting to do this. Look, full disclosure, my brother worked with Connecticut and New Jersey as the governor of New York. They're opening up golf courses, marinas, parks. You know, I don't think they have a great plan for testing in place among the states. I don't think they have great pooled capacity. But the pull of opening seems to be the strongest part of the mix right now. What do you do about that?
Chris, my mom owned a hair salon for over 25 years, so I understand the economic pull on this. This would have been devastating to my family for her to have to shut down her business for weeks on end. But you have to live to be able to fight another day. And so when we're talking about this economic pull and getting to recovery, if we're not alive on the other side of it, then there won't be a recovery to be had. And again, let's look at the data. We see our numbers are continuing to tick up in this state. We see that our deaths are rising. We have some of the highest asthma rates in the country right here in Atlanta. Our governor often defers to local control, and I wish that this were an instance that he deferred to local control. I don't know how you get a haircut and keep a safe distance from someone who's cutting your bangs. It just doesn't make sense to me. And so I look forward. Go ahead.
Go ahead, Mayor. We're here to hear you.
Yeah, I want to understand the logic behind this. You know, there are people hurting economically. I think that the better use of our energy would be to do things like we've done in Atlanta. We have launched a small business fund to help people in need of grants. We're launching a beauty and barbershop fund to help people who have hair salons. We have deferred water bill payments. We've suspended evictions through our housing authority. There are a lot of things that we can do to make this more palatable for people to be able to stay home. But when you talk about small businesses, a lot of people don't even have health insurance who own small businesses. And so these are our most vulnerable in more ways than one.
So I just want to make something clear. You say you have a good working relationship with the governor. But just to be clear here, he makes this move faster than even the president is asking anybody to make it. You never talked to him about this? He didn't consult with you as the mayor of Atlanta about what it would mean for your city before he pulled the trigger?
Let me be clear. The governor is the governor. So he did not have to consult with me. But the answer is no, he did not consult with me. And as the largest city... You know, I can't explain it because I know the governor to be a man of reason. And so I don't know why the governor didn't consult with me. I'm not sure who the governor consulted with other than who he said he consulted with. But we've created a business council in Atlanta to help advise us on when and how we should begin to open back up for business at the appropriate time.
Well, Mayor, let's do this. You're obviously going to have eyes on the situation. You always have an open channel here to tell us what's happening, what you're able to respond to and what you can't. So we have full information for people there and, of course, all over the region and the country. Mayor Keisha Lance Bottoms, thank you very much. Be safe. Best to your family.
Thank you. Okay, y'all, we hear Nancy's.